Can you run Python code online in 2021? Well, let's find out what you can do first with websites and then with Google Colab. To test what we can do online, we've got some code. First of all, some simple code like a for loop. Then we ask the user to input a number. Then we're going to use import. First of all, with a simple module that's already in Python called math, and one that normally you have to install called NumPy. And finally, we're going to see if we can open and read a file using the online Python editors. So we put run Python online into Google, and we've got 5 online Python editors. And let's test these to see how they cope with our little tests. So we're going to start off with a code that goes through a for loop and then asks for input from a user. So let's try this code. Okay, it looks okay. Let's put the number 7 in, enter, that's printed okay. So that's fine. Let's try the next editor. We put our code in, this says execute. So we run the program. Oh, it's give us an error message. Not so good. Now let's try the next editor. We've got run and see if our solution is down the bottom. A bit small, but looks okay. We enter 7 again, that looks fine. And now fourth option, we can put our code in. We're going to run. It says running our code in the output. Little delay. Okay, is your program accepting inputs from a user? Let's see if we can run that again. Okay, not so great. And editor number 5, our final one, we're going to run. Different. We've got a box for our number. Put in 7. Okay, so we've gone through our for loop and then we've printed our number. So 3 out of 5 on the first task. Test 2, we're going to try to import math and NumPy. We're going to try import math, which you'd expect to work on online editor. Import NumPy would not normally come with your Python download, so you would have to install it separately, like pip install. So let's try and run this and see if we get the answer. The square root would be 3 and the version. Yes, so that's worked on our first editor. So let's copy that. Our second one, not a great start. Let's see how it gets on with here. We execute the code. This has worked as well. Our third editor, you can run the code. Yes, that's worked, that's good. Let's try our fourth one. We're running, wait for the output, and we've got 3 and we've got a version. And our final editor, we're going to run. No module name math. So 4 out of 5 on the import test. Now to finally test these editors to see if they can do what we can do on our computer, let's try to read words from a text file and count them. Well, the question was, can you run Python online? And yes, you can. But is the answer, it depends. Well, our final task, we're going to open up a text file that's on our computer. So let's try and see what happens. Okay, no such file. A second editor, let's try, execute. No such file. Third editor is not going so well. Let's run. And down the bottom, we've got error, no such file. Fourth editor, now we've got run, our output. Will it ask us to find the file or will it just give us an error message? Okay, no such file. And finally, our fifth editor, our fifth online editor, type error is undefined. So that didn't work either. Let's just try that again. Okay, it's not going to work. So all five of our online editors can run Python, but once you start including things like adding files to your code, then there are elements of Python code that they won't run. If you've got a Google account, you'll probably use your Gmail. So if we go into your email and click the nine small dots, you can see other services from Google. So if we look down, we can see Drive, that's Google Drive. So now a window opens with the Google Drive. Now this drive is empty, there's no files in here. We click on New, and under More you may see Google's Colab. If it's not there, you click under More Apps and we'll get a box with more apps, and we can search for Colab. So we have Collaboratory. So we're going to click on that find, and here we are. So we click and we're going to install it. Continue. Okay. Get ready to install. Done. Okay. So now once we click New and More, now we have Google Collaboratory. So Google Colab. So now we click on Google Colab, and we're going to get a new document. So for the first time, this window will open up. Now, you see this seems a bit confusing, but if we just want to put our code in, we can copy and paste our code, and we're going to click Run. And the first time, we expect to see the for loop. We're going to print the 0 to 8, and then we're going to ask for give us a number. So again, because this is the first time and we just set it up, it's taken a little while. Normally it's pretty much immediate. So first time it's set up. Okay, so now it's give us our numbers, give us a number, and we put 7 in, return, and it's running again, and it's give us our number 7. Okay, so what else did we want to do? Well, we wanted to try to import, so let's import math. So go back and let's paste our code again and run. That's quite straightforward. What about NumPy? Let's try that. Okay, when we run it, okay, so we've got NumPy there. Now, what about the last test about opening a text file? So we've got this file on our computer, but it's how's our system online going to find it? When we run this, it says no such file or directory. So how do we get around that? Well, we can upload the file. So let's see if we can upload the file for any text. So we open. Okay, so it's saying that while we've got this open, then that file is there. But once we close this window, it's gone. We'll have to upload it again. Okay, let's put the full code in. So we have the full code when we run this. Okay, so now we can see our data from our file. So we uploaded the folder, the file in a folder, and then we can run our code using the Google Colab. You can change the name of the file. So here we've got all words, and then that will save it into your Google Drive. So let's have a look in Google Drive. Let's update this. We can see we've got our all words. We can save a copy in Drive. And if we go back to Drive, hopefully, we can see we've got a copy of all words. So we've got the folder. We've got the file all words stored in our Google Drive. Okay, another thing that we've seen when people look at Google Colab is using this code of files upload. So here we've got the folder already uploaded. But what we can do is we can change our code. So what we're going to do is from Google's Colab, we're going to actually upload the file. So when we run this, you'll see here we've got an option with a browse button, and then we can look inside our computer and find the file. Once we've opened it up, we can see our file. We've got our text file, and now we've found that file, and then we can run the code, and then we've got our count of the words. So that's another way we can access the file by using this browse, by using this file equals files upload. So Google Colab, associated more with advanced machine learning and neural networks, but you can use it for just simple Python code. If you learn anything from these videos, then why not subscribe, and then you'll be notified when a new video comes out. And it's great if you can leave a comment or click like.